Hi everyone, I just wanted to quickly invite you all to a little event that some of us in the community like to participate in. It's called Advent of Code. It's an online event not hosted by ServiceNow, nor is it an official program that we run. It's just something fun a bunch of us do every December. So it's adventofcode.com, this website right here. It's a website where for the first 25 days of December, a different coding puzzle is released and we race each other to solve the problem. A lot of us actually don't race and just try to complete the daily puzzles. We like to see how far we get into December before the puzzles either get too hard or too time consuming. But at the start, it can be pretty fun. And if you are interested in challenging yourself and kind of honing your JavaScript skills, this is a fun way for us ServiceNow developers to kind of practice our coding prowess. So if that's interesting to you, come and join us. We are mostly hanging out on the sndevs.com server on the Advent of Code channel. So you can find the link to that in the description and then come join us. And we have a daily thread where we talk about the puzzle, how we went about solving it and all that good stuff. But let me show you how to get started. So first things first, you're going to go to adventofcode.com and you're going to create an account. You need to log in first and then you're going to be able to join our leaderboard. There is a leaderboard that is hosted by Astrid, and you'll be able to find that join code inside of the channel where we're all chatting. So join the chat channel, and then you'll be able to find the join code there to jump into this leaderboard. But once you have an account and you log in, you'll see the calendar up and down the screen, the 1 through 25. So every day, one new puzzle gets released, and you can see a countdown here. But the very first puzzle, you click on it, and it has this big story to make it a little bit more fun. And then it has a puzzle in it. And then it has an example question, like example input that you can test your code against. And then you also get a puzzle input. You get an actual input file that has all of your input that you're supposed to run your code against to get the actual answer. And then every day you're going to type in your answer and then press submit. And it'll tell you if you got the right answer, if you got the wrong answer. But generally speaking, you're going to go into each day's puzzle. You're going to read through what the puzzle is, and then you're going to get to the actual problem. And you're eventually going to find what you need to do to solve that puzzle. And so today it's saying we have to compare these lists some way, and it gives us an example of data. So I'm going to copy this, and then I'm going to go ahead and jump over to my personal developer instance. So developer.servicenow.com. And then if you don't have an instance already, you can request one. But once you have an instance, you can click Start Building and it'll bring you into your own ServiceNow instance. And you can go to scripts-background and you'll get a little code box. And for some people, this might be the most comfortable place for you to do this event because you're used to only coding inside ServiceNow. So this is where you might want to be for this. And I have that input saved and I'm going to paste it into this box. You'll notice I have some errors, but I'll get back to that. And then I want to make sure to test to see if I did that correctly. You'll notice that I have these little red squigglies saying that, hey, I typed in the string incorrectly. And that's because when you do a string with multi-line, the quotation marks don't work. So what we're going to do is we're going to change this to the backtick. It's the same key as the tilde key for a lot of you. So we're going to change these quotation marks to a backtick. And you'll notice that now the code will run, but before it would have errored. And so it is telling me my script back to me. And now we're just going to try to solve for the puzzle. And so from here, it just depends on what the puzzle is and what we're supposed to be doing with this input. Yesterday was the first day of Advent of Code. So let's read a little bit of what we're going to do, and we're going to walk through day one together. So this is saying that given this list of numbers, we want to pair up the smallest number in the left list with the smallest number on the right list. Then the second smallest number in the left list with the second smallest number in the right list, and so on. And so the process of Advent of Code is a lot of you read through the problem, and then you just start thinking of, well, what do I need to do step by step? And so we can actually start working on that. First of all, we want to change this list into something that we can iterate through. And so we want two lists, a list of only the left numbers and then a list of only the right numbers. So we're going to need to parse that input and go through it to get it into two different lists. So let's do that first. Okay, so you can see here, first I'm going to take this big long string and I'm going to break it apart according to the new lines. And if I test this, yeah, you'll see it's the first line and then the second line and a third line, and now it's in an array. So further, I'm going to then go through each of these lines. So var I and input, and if I log each input line and test that, okay, now I'm doing it one line at a time. And because there's a bunch of spaces in between it, see, 1, 2, 3, exactly 3 spaces. I'll just copy that right now. I'm going to split this even further by those 3 spaces. And then if I log this line and run it, there. And now we have some workable data to work with. I wanted to make 2 arrays, one with the first numbers and one with the second numbers. And so I'm going to set that up. We're going to say var array 1 equals a blank array, and var array 2 equals another blank array. And for each of these lines, we're going to push the first index, the 0 index of this line array, and then we're going to push second index of this line's array. And now if I, at the very end, log array 1 and then log array 2 and run that, now I have array 1 of 3, 4, 2, 1, 3, 3. So let's verify that's correct. 3, 4, 1, 3, 4, 2, 1, 3, 3. That's right. And then the next one should be 4, 3, 5, 3, 9, 3. 4, 3, 5, 3, 9, 3. Perfect. Now I've taken the input and I've changed it to where I need the data to be so that I can continue. And so from there, it's a matter of just solving, thinking through it. Like, okay, according to the puzzle, we need to now sort the arrays. So the next part of my code, I would figure out a way to make each of these arrays go from smallest to largest. And then after that, I would do the comparison of the left one to the right one according to the rules that it's telling me to follow. And there's a bunch of rules for day one. And you'll see that it says, we're going to compare each of the numbers and see how far apart they are. So if the first number on this list is a 1, and the next one on the other list it's a 3, that means there's a difference of 2. And then we will add up all the differences, because that's what the puzzle wants us to do, and figure out what the total difference between all of those pairs are. And in this example case, it'll even tell you what's the right answer. The example one is 11. And so after you figure that out, it's a matter of taking your puzzle input and copying all of that and changing your input to that big long one, and then running your script for that big input. And you'll see, here's my new data that I'd be working with for that one. But that's the beauty of coding, right? Because even when you have the really large input, as long as you coded it right, even if you have a really big input compared to your test small input, it should still work. So that's the fun of admin of code. If you want to take it one step further and start coding in a much more streamlined way inside of your personal developer instance, because it can be a little clunky to be coding in this little box, one thing that a lot of us do is we set up our admin of code inside of VS Code. And I've made a walkthrough on how to do that. Go to my GitHub repository on admin of code. It'll be in the description. And once you get there, you can actually follow the instructions on how I set up my VS Code to be able to do admin of code. I'll show you a little bit of that right now. Okay, so now we're looking at my VS Code, and you can see in here that For day one, I had an example text. So that's where that example input that we used earlier, I just copy and pasted it in here. I have my separate file just for input, and that's my big long one that I copied and pasted. And then I have my actual code file, and I have all this little template set up that you'll be able to copy and paste. But then I am able to code all of my stuff inside of here. And if I press my Control-Shift-P or Command-Shift-P for Mac, there is a Run Active File and Active Terminal button, and it actually runs my code inside of VS Code. And I can actually see my working code for this day's answer. And so it's just a lot easier for us to work into the here because we can not deal with the big, long text files of our input, and we can run the code back-to-back over inside of the terminal so that we don't have to keep going back and forth between pages. So it's a little bit of an easy way for us to handle it. After you solve for the day one puzzle, you'll actually notice that it's two parts every day. So you'll answer part one of your puzzle and you'll get an answer. And when you get it correct, it unlocks part two. Part two is usually some interesting twist on part one. And so instead, it'll be like, oh, so we forgot this one rule. Now you need to change your code a little bit to solve for this additional twist. You'll walk through part two and then try to answer that too. For every puzzle you solve, you gain a star. And so you'll see a bunch of us have either silver stars or gold stars. The silver star means you completed part one for that day. And then the gold star means you completed part two for that day. And so we're all have started gaining our stars. You can even go back to previous years and do those puzzles too. But yeah, that's Advent of Code. I hope you join us because it is fun. It's fun for me to test my JavaScript skills every year. So yeah, come join. Bye.